Hello, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Communication is such an important aspect. We learn from the moment we are born. So communication is inbuilt in ourselves and we have our own styles of communicating. At office, we want to be heard. So let's look at this video from an office perspective. And it's not much different. It's not at all different from our personal lives too. But let's kind of think this video from an office perspective. We want our ideas to be heard, right, at office. But many times, it doesn't go even if it's the best idea. It doesn't get accepted even if it's the best idea. Probably because the way it is communicated, right? As they say in today's corporate, you not just have a good idea. It's not important that you just have one good idea. It's also important that you communicate it effectively. And that's what this video is about, as to how we can improve how to communicate effectively at workplace. So to be heard and communicate effectively, there are basically four types of communication styles. One is, so there is a doer, there is a feeler, there's one as a thinker, and there's one as an imaginer. I would like to explain a little bit into each of these communication styles. A doer is the one who wants to get results. They focus on the present. A doer values action and achievement and progress. They see a team task straight with the kind of goal of completing the task, and they have the most simple minds. A feeler is a one who is most connected with the emotions of others. Feelers are motivated by their contribution and they think the same too for others as well. A thinker is those set of people who believe in data, who believe in kind of logic, and they're very structured in their problem solving. They wait for, if there's a group who's discussing on a particular topic, they wait for the majority of them to speak. They'll consider all possible thoughts, analyze them, and then they will share the thoughts. They want each and every details when communication is being given to them. Yeah? And the next one is an imaginer. They're always in the future, thinking of the bigger picture and want the why to be answered in their communications. They're very creative and they keep coming up with great ideas. You know, as they say, the best way to communicate is to communicate in the way they want to be communicated. So how to communicate with each other? So let's go one by one. For a doer, if you're communicating with a doer, just get to the point. Don't beat around the bush. Discuss on the action points and how to achieve them. Don't talk about things which are not relevant to the task or to the issue. And when you're communicating with a feeler, have small talks. Small talks are very important. Ask about them. How did their day go about? Try to make those small talks where they connect with you. And whenever they make even small contributions, appreciate them. They will be motivated. It's very important, even small contributions, to be appreciated. And identify the emotions of the feelers and work around for that issue. When you're communicating with a thinker, have data, facts prepared. They'll love it. And make your communication slow, because they keep weighing the facts, the numbers and all through their thoughts while you are communicating them to them. So before you communicate your full thoughts, also make sure they are with you and you also understand as to what their opinion in between, because they're weighing the options and their opinion in between as you're communicating to them. And when you're communicating with an imaginer, they're all future focused. Have what is that which is there in the future that they can benefit out of this, Okay, so when you're communicating, have those future focused messages, have the future part of the actions also inbuilt in your communications, which will interest them. They will be more interested to know what is probably, when you're communicating about a strategy, try to understand how is this going to impact the organization in the long run. So they are going to be future focused. They're thinking about the bigger pictures. So communicate also on what this strategy is, or what is this communication going to have an impact on the long run as well. So these are some of the four basic communication styles. So one thing you need to keep in mind is things will take time and effort. So keep putting your effort. And before you start the four ways which I kind of showed you, understand what kind of communicator are you. So understand what kind of a style do you adopt. Do you like to be when you are receiving a communication? So that will help you to understand what kind of a communication style do you adopt. Yeah, that's more important. So is this enough to know? Will this make you an effective communicator? No. Then what to do? Step one. Make a list of the regular people you meet daily or even on a regular basis. Can be your manager, your super manager, can be your reportees, can be your co-workers. Categorize them on your understanding and experience. What kind of communication style do these people fall into? Categorize them into the four categories I showed you. Step three, understand what kind of a communicator are you, right? And step four, align your style to each of those categories. So next time when you're probably, if you've understood that you are a doer and you understand that one of your reportee or one of your co-worker is a feeler, try to make those small talks. Although you are a doer, you would like to get straight away to the point, but your reportee or your co-worker is a feeler. Try to make those small talks. So you are able to adjust your communication styles to each of those categories. Okay. And the last, and I believe that's the most important step, is this is not a magic trick. The key to it is you need to keep practicing. Okay, sometimes it happens that your categorization of your understanding is also different from what the person is really is or are. So you got to keep experimenting with your methods. You got to keep putting efforts to understand the kind of people they are, and accordingly, because your style is not going to change, you know what kind of communication style do you adopt personally, right? So you will be able to align your style to each of those person and categories, and that will help you to communicate effectively your thoughts, your strategies to the person. So this is what I believe is how we can improve our communications effectively at workplace. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I would be really happy to know the feedback for this video. So you could reach out to me on the contact details provided, either in the form of a phone number, or you can just drop in an email to me, or you could also connect with me on LinkedIn as Prasad SM, or here is the URL for my LinkedIn profile. So thank you once again for watching this video, and do connect and let me know your feedback in the comment section also. Thank you.